Yes, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this our PEEX session, and I will now speak about PEEX potential. And we have a really big potential in PEEX. We have comprehensive observations. We have, of course, all this our PEEX agenda. I speak also a little bit about science diplomacy and things related to present COVID-19 situation. And if we start from very beginning in having some background related to our PEEX activities, we have this China atmospheric cocktail. With pollution, here you see the pollution part and here's the clean part, and then also we need to build up this global Earth observatory to really find out how many stations we need all around the world. And of course PEEX area is one of the key part there. Okay, and if you think about this, how PEEX can contribute to solving global grand challenges. And in grand challenges, we have increasing population, and what do we need? We need good food, fresh water, fresh air, energy. And what we get, climate is changing, we have air quality issues, we have challenges to supply enough fresh water and good food. We have acidification, deforestation, chemicalization, biodiversity losses, and problems in energy supply. And right now, of course, we have this global epidemic disease pandemic that is going on. And really to solve this, we need joint work between different disciplines. We need science diplomacy, we need observations, and we need to go from ideas to implementation. And one of those things, what we can of course think about, we have here our PEEX area, Arctic and Boreal, and then other branch of PEEX area, which is China and other Eastern Asia countries, which are certainly key areas to study. For example, this kind of feedback loops, or find out new feedback loops. In these feedback loops, we look at when photosynthesis is increasing, what happens to volatile organic compound increase, what happens to aerosol effect, what happens then to diffuse to global radiation change. Or to when the ratio is changing. And in practice, we can also think about carbon sink and how much bigger is carbon sink plus. But this is important that besides PEEX area, we need globally to look other key areas like Amazonas, like these deserts in Sahara, etc., and South and then Africa. And also large metropolitan areas. Here is Moscow. And most of metropolitan areas are actually inside this PEEX area. What is actually needed if you want to answer or solve or meet these grand challenges? We need world-class research infrastructures and an integrated network of research infrastructures. We need excellent science, quality, critical mass, and interdisciplinary research. We need education and training, knowledge exchange, innovations contributing to innovation environment, and science to society, continuous dialogue, including specialty science diplomacy. And very important part is open access to research infrastructures, to data, and data today is pretty heterogeneous and challenging to manage. That's why we need to organize an easy access to the data and also some platform to harmonized and standardized ways to analyze it. And if we think about the global point of view, inside this circle, about half of the global population is living. And inside this red triangle, there is around 10% of the global population lives inside this red area. And now a couple of things related to this present corona situation. We have observations in Beijing. And what do we see? We know from statistics that the traffic density has gone down about to 1/3 of the original one. It's around 30% it has been during the COVID lockdown. And we see also that before we have this kind of new particle formation growing to haze particles, but also after we see the same. We see actually that about the same formation rate, same new particle formation frequency, and about the same haze situation, PM2.5. The reason for that we have much more oxidation capacity. We have more secondary production of pollution. We have much more ozone. We have less NOx, etc. And this kind of thing we have now studied pretty carefully, and this is quite interesting way of looking it. In x-axis is now actually the time over polluted area, and y-axis we have diameter of particles, and color code shows that how much particles we had to certain size class. And before the corona issue, which is actually before the Chinese New Year, Chinese Spring Festival, we see that the concentrations are pretty similar at the last hours over the polluted area. And actually at the beginning, it also a little bit increased. But here, if we have been only very short time over polluted area, which we have now as a measure like potential CO exposure, we have much less big particles. We start smaller ones, and actually we have very similar type of new particle formation event than we have had earlier. And this after spring festival, which means during this corona lockdown, we see very clearly that at the end, this situation is about the same, but we have this growing type, and the dynamics and oxidations happens very differently. Also, we can look at these sources of different material, and we can easily see that if you look at this secondary, which is this blue one, versus primary emissions of aerosol particles, there are clear domination of the secondary activities. And here is this x-axis is the total mass concentration. And actually the more higher mass concentration is the higher secondary fraction we have. Something about science diplomacy. We have been, as a PEEX, we have been part of this Silk Road activities. We have a direct work together with Silk Road and Arctic activities. We have been able to discuss directly with the president of Finland, President Sauli Niinistö. And we have, of course, direct dialogue with Russian Geographical Society and Chinese Academy of Science, and also Russian Academy of Science. And the initiatives where we have been active in those peaks, of course, Global SMER, Global Observatory, and we are also in leading this European Center of International Eurasian Academy of Sciences. And I met the president of China last January, And now this is idea is to be a very short introduction to the topic. If I remember correctly, Hanna gave me 10 to 15 minutes. And let's say that I'm really very happy to see that PEEX, our Pan-Eurasian experiments, has really great potential. And especially this kind of multi-scale, multidisciplinary, multidimensional way what we have had in PEEX is really, really useful. And that's why I'm looking forward that during this meeting where we are able to get more and more new ideas and really go on in our activities. Thank you.